Half a day, everyone. It is another amazing brain-teasing episode with the 50th anniversary of the Academic Challenge Bowl. I'm your host, Ernest Ochoco, and this is my student co-host.
Hello, everyone. I'm Dominique Rivera, and in this episode, we have John F. Kennedy versus Okudu.
All right, let's get to it. Let's get to know our contestants today.
Let's start with John F. Kennedy. Please tell me your name and your grade.
Hello, my name is Emmy Bott. I am a senior.
Hello, my name is Nichelle Torsellino, and I am a freshman.
Hi, I'm Jimmy K. Daniel, and I'm a senior.
Hello, my name is Shirianne Marquez, and I am a freshman.
All right, and let's have Okudu. Same thing, name and grade.
Hello, my name is Robert Bermeo, and I'm a junior.
Hi, my name is Darian Beharano-Schulte, and I am a senior.
Hi, my name is Mikayla Abad, and I am a senior.
Hi, my name is Megan Canales, and I am a senior.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet all of you, and good luck to all of you guys. All right, here we go. In the first round, each question is worth 10 points. And when time is up, you'll hear this.
Time's up.
You guys good? Okay. We're gonna start with buoyancy. What is the SI unit of measurement of buoyancy? John F. Kennedy, Jimmy.
Grams per cubic centimeter.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct answer is Newton or N. Linear equations. What is the value of X in this equation? You will have 20 seconds. Open parentheses, 3x minus 42, close parentheses, slash 9 equals 2, open parentheses, 7 minus x, close parentheses. Your time begins now.
Time's up.
The correct answer is 8. Plate tectonics. Which of the world's great plates is bounded on the northeast by the Arabian plate, the southeast by the Indo-Australian plate? Okudu, Robert.
The African plate?
You are correct. It is the African plate. Theaters. The Abbey Theatre, home to National Theatre Society, is in what Irish city? Okudu, Robert.
Dublin.
You are correct. Ancient cities. Who were original inhabitants of Machu Picchu? John F. Kennedy, Emmy.
The Incans.
You are correct. It is the Incans or Incas. Anatomy. A group of several separate organs integrated to perform some special function make up what? Okudu, Robert.
An organ system.
I will take that. Organ system is correct. Parts of speech. What part of speech is the last word in this example? Although Hazel looked far and wide for both toadworts and garbanzo beans, she found neither. We have John F. Kennedy, Jimmy.
Noun.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct answer is pronoun. What term in business refers to the lowering or reduction of a price? John F. Kennedy, Emmy.
Discount.
That is correct. Volcano geography. Since Krinikotan is an active volcano in the Kuril Islands, it belongs to what country? Okudu, Robert.
Russia.
You are correct. Political proverbs. According to the proverb, the world is ruled by the hand that rocks what? We have John F. Kennedy, Jimmy.
The cradle.
Yes, you are correct. First aid. What is an EMT doing when she presses two fingers against the radial artery? John F. Kennedy, Jimmy.
Checking the pulse.
Yes, you are correct. Arithmetic means. Insert four arithmetic means between 2 and 17. You will have 20 seconds to answer this question, starting now. Thank you.
Time's up.
The correct answer is 5, 8, 11, and 14. Statehood. What was the last southern state to be readmitted to the Union? John F. Kennedy, Emmy.
South Carolina.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct answer is Georgia. Ascorbic acid is a name for what vitamin? John F. Kennedy, Jimmy?
Vitamin C.
You are correct. Examinations. What is the Latin word for an autopsy?
Time's up.
The correct answer is post-mortem. Island chains. The Lesser Antilles are closest to what continent? Ukudu Robert.
South America.
Yes, you are correct. It is South America. International relations. What is the title of the diplomatic representative of one country authorized to deal directly with the king? John F. Kennedy, Emmy?
Ambassador.
You are correct. Energy. Prior to 1941, it was the world's chief fuel and it is likely to return to first place as oil and gas reserves run out. John F. Kennedy, Emmy?
Nuclear.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct answer is coal. This will be the last question. Algebraic operations. You will have 20 seconds to answer this. From 3p minus 2, subtract negative 7p plus 5. John F. Kennedy, Jimmy.
10p minus 7.
You are correct. Okay, and that is the last question for the first round. Now we have JFK with 80 points and Ukudu High School with 50 points. Now it's time for the lightning round. You'll need to choose a representative who will be answering for your team. Remember, you are only given 1 minute and 10 seconds to answer all 10 questions. And the person who is representing you can be the only person who answers. Since your school is with the highest points, JFK, then you can make the decision for which category you're going to play. Your categories are environment or myths and legends.
Which one are you going to do? Yeah, go for it.
I will be representing John F. Kennedy, and our category will be myths and legends.
Okay, fantastic. Remember, we'll go through this as fast as we can, and if you pass, we'll go back to those that you passed on, okay? Here we go. Your time begins now. What are the two Greek gods depicting opposite expressions of theater called?
Pass.
In Norse mythology, which god was killed with a mistletoe?
Balder.
You're correct. Around 146 BC, the Romans conquered the Greek peninsula, integrating the Greek gods in their religion. Which Greek god was renamed Jupiter?
Zeus.
You are correct. In American mythology, which lumberjack of enormous stature had a giant blue ox named Babe for a sidekick?
Pass.
Medusa, along with her sisters, could turn people into stone by just looking at them. What are these creatures called?
Pass.
Butch Cassidy had a fast companion. What was his name?
Pass.
President Theodore Roosevelt refused to shoot a bound bear. Because of this, they named this famous toy after him.
The teddy bear.
You are correct. Which famous historical figure would alert the British invasion if he saw one light in the church
Paul
by
Revere.
Land? You are correct. In Egyptian mythology, who was the god of the sun?
Ra.
Time's up.
Okay. Great job. That is the end of the first lightning round. You have a total of 50 points, and you have answered 5 questions correctly. For the audience's benefit, let's go ahead and go through the questions that you missed. What are the two Greek gods depicting opposite expressions in theater called? That is comedy and tragedy. You also missed, in American mythology, which lumberjack of enormous stature had a giant blue ox? That is Paul Bunyan. Medusa, along with her sisters, could turn people into stone. They were called Gorgons. Butch Cassidy had a fast companion. His name was the Sundance Kid. And the question that we didn't even get to was question number 10. Which mythological creature that is closely associated with fire represents immortality, resurrection, and life after death? It is the phoenix. And now it's time for Ukudu's lightning round. Who will be representing your team?
I'm Robert Romeo, and I'll be representing Ukudu.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yes.
Your category is environment. And your time starts now. Which rays from the sun is affecting the people who live in the higher altitude areas above sea level?
UV rays.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The gas which has a major role in the greenhouse effect is?
Carbon dioxide.
You are correct. The spiral which explains the effect of wind on the ocean mathematically is?
TAF.
Who coined the term ecology in 1870?
TAF.
Animals which are lively in the daytime and rest in the night are called?
TAF.
When there is a discharge of sulfur dioxide into the atmosphere, it will cause what environmental phenomenon?
TAF.
The country which decommissioned all of its nuclear reactors is?
TAF.
Which are the three primary greenhouse gases?
Carbon dioxide, methane, and...
That is incorrect. Who is the visionary who warned about the climate changes caused by the combustion of fossil fuels by mankind?
TAF.
Time's up.
I'll go ahead and continue and finish the last question. What is the phenomena that occurs when sunlight passes through rain?
Rainbows.
You are correct. Okay. You have a total of 20 points, and you have two questions correct. Okay. And your final score for round one is JFK, 130 points, and Ukudu High School with 70 points. The answers that you missed were, number one, which rays from the sun is affecting the people who live in the higher altitude areas? They're called cosmic rays. The spiral which explains the effect of wind on the ocean mathematically is called the Ekman spiral. Who coined the term ecology in 1870 was Ernest Hackett. Animals which are lively in the daytime and rest in the night are called diurnal animals. When there is a discharge of sulfur dioxide into the atmosphere, it will cause acid rain. The country which decommissioned all of its nuclear reactors is Sweden. What are the three primary greenhouse gases? You were actually really close. Carbon dioxide, methane, and chlorofluorocarbons. Who is the visionary who warned about the climate changes? That is Guy Stewart Callender. And of course, that is the end of our first round. JFK has 130 points, and Ukudu has 70. Good job, everyone. Okay, and that's it for Academic Challenge Bowl Round 1. We'll be back after this break.
Welcome back to the second half of Academic Challenge Bowl. The current score is John F. Kennedy with 130 points and Ukudu with 70 points. And I see we have some substitutions, so if you guys could introduce yourself with your name and grade, please.
Hello, my name is Erica Conde. I'm a 10th grader at JFK High School.
All right, and at Ukudu?
Hello, my name is John Sumang, and I'm a senior at Ukudu High School.
All right, thank you guys. In round two, the questions will be worth 20 points. You will also have 5 seconds to answer questions, and you will have 20 seconds if there are any math equations. Let's start off with round two. Drama vocabulary. What term rhyming with balloon indicates a jester? John F. Kennedy, Jimmy?
Buffoon.
That is correct. Latitudes. The five notable latitudes of Earth include the equator, the two polar circles, the Tropic of Cancer, and what other? John F. Kennedy, Emmy?
The Tropic of Capricorn.
That is correct. Monuments. Ellis Island is part of what other national monument? John F. Kennedy, Erica?
Statue of Liberty.
That is correct. Outlaws. What name for a bold outlaw of the American frontier was derived from a Latin word meaning despair? John F. Kennedy, Jimmy?
Desperado.
That is correct. Pond degradation. What aquatic photosynthetic organisms are prolific in ponds undergoing? Okadu, Robert?
Algae.
That is correct. Asian borders. What country on its north has a short border with Russia and a long border? Okadu, Robert?
North Korea.
That is correct. Quandaries. To whom do the pronouns refer in this excerpt from a recent novel? Pulled in one direction by her intense passion for Edward Cullen, and in another by her profound connection to werewolf Jacob Black, she endures a tumultuous year deciding whether to join the dark world of immortals or pursue a fully human life. Okadu, Megan?
Bella Swan.
That is correct. Measurement. The number of times that an event recurs per unit of time is a measure of what? John F. Kennedy, Emmy?
Frequency.
That is correct. Chimneys. While a cylindrical chimney is a smokestack, what is the name for a ship's smokestack?
Time's up.
The answer is funnel. European ages. The Victorian age flourished during which century? Okadu, Robert?
The 19th century.
That is correct. Archipelagos. What World Heritage Site consisting of Ecuadorian islands is associated with Charles? Okadu, Robert?
The Galapagos Islands.
That is correct. Petrology. Strata or beds are the single most characteristic feature of what general class of rock? John F. Kennedy, Emmy?
Igneous.
That is incorrect. The answer is sedimentary rock. British matrimony. In 2011, amidst great pomp, who became the bride of Prince William? John F. Kennedy, Emmy?
Meghan Markle.
That is incorrect. The answer is Kate Middleton. Gases. What is the principal gas that is commercially prepared by removing the oxygen from air? John F. Kennedy, Jimmy?
Nitrogen.
That is correct. Ladies of Domremy La Pucelle. What French woman who was burned at the stake in 14... John F. Kennedy, Jimmy?
Joan of Arc.
That is correct. Chinese history. The palace complex in central Beijing, China is known as what city? John F. Kennedy, Jimmy?
The Forbidden City.
That is correct. Diamonds, multiple choice. Which is not among the world's top 10 diamond producing countries? A, Russia, B, Canada, C, Angola, D, South Africa, or E, the United States? Okadu, Robert?
E, the United States.
That is correct. Rodents. Rodents lack what kind of teeth that humans, apes, canines, and feet? Okadu, Robert?
Molars.
That is incorrect. The answer is canines. Elections. Elections. What state has the greatest number of delegates in the Electoral College? John F. Kennedy, Emmy?
California.
That is correct. Constellation appellations. What is the meaning of the first words in the names of these constellations? Corona Australis and Okadu, Robert?
Crown.
That is correct. Bad days. Franklin Roosevelt's day of infamy occurred in what month? Okadu, Robert?
December.
That is correct. Tarantulas. There are two main regions of a tarantula's body, including the prosoma, another name for the cephalothorax, and the opisthosoma, which is another name for what region? Okadu, Robert?
The head.
That is incorrect. The answer is the abdomen. The sun, multiple choice. What layer of the sun's atmosphere is just below the chromosphere? John F. Kennedy, Emmy?
The photosphere.
That is correct. Battleships. Name Germany's largest battleship of the... John F. Kennedy, Emmy?
The Bismarck.
That is correct. Artistic individuality. During what general period in European history did artists begin to routinely sign their works, thereby helping to make a name for themselves as individuals? Okadu, Robert?
The Baroque period.
That is incorrect. The answer is the Renaissance. Pronoun classifications, multiple choice. Classify the pronoun they. Is it A, relative, B, objective, C, reflexive, D, subjective, or E, demonstrative? John F. Kennedy, Jimmy?
D, F in dog.
That is correct. And this is our last question, and it is a 20-second math question. Amperage. To the nearest tenth, what amperage is needed by a half-horsepower motor requiring 120 volts?
Time's up!
The answer is 3.1. And that is the end of our second round. The current score is JFK with 370 and Okadu with 230. And now it's time for the lightning round. You'll need to choose a representative who will be answering for your team. John F. Kennedy, since you're the school with the highest points, you get to choose which category you want to play. You can choose either famous quotes or philosophy.
I will be representing JFK, and our category is philosophy.
All right. You will have 1 minute and 10 seconds to answer. Each question is worth 20 points for a possible total of 200 points. And remember, you can pass at any time, and if we have more time, we can go back to all the questions you passed on. All right. And time starts now. What is the meaning of philosophy?
Pass.
The various ways of knowing, the nature of truth, and the relationship between knowledge and belief is explored by this theory.
Pass.
Philosophers often distinguish between how many kinds of knowledge, and what are they?
Pass.
How many types of reasoning are there? Which are they?
Pass.
Which is the study of the nature of right and wrong and the distinction between good and evil?
Pass.
Which states that all moral standards are subjective to matters of taste or opinion?
Pass.
What is the study of art and beauty called?
Pass.
What do you call a person who has no religious beliefs?
Atheist.
That is correct. Which two fields studies the natural phenomena and the phenomena of society?
Pass.
This philosophical quote is from the Bible. He who has not sinned cast the first stone. Who said it?
Jesus.
That is correct. What is the meaning of philosophy?
The study of the mind.
That is incorrect. The various ways of knowing, the nature of truth, and the relationship between knowledge and belief is explored by this theory.
Time's up.
Do you have an answer? Okay. And that is the end of our lightning round. You answered 2 questions correctly for a total of 40 points. And of course, for our viewing audience, I'll go over the questions we missed. What is the meaning of philosophy? The love of wisdom. The various ways of knowing, the nature of truth, and the relationship between knowledge and belief is explored by this theory, epistemology. Philosophers often distinguish between how many kinds of knowledge and what are they, priori and empirical. How many types of reasoning are there, and which are they, deductive and inductive? Which is the study of the nature of right and wrong and the distinction between good and evil, ethics? Which states that all moral standards are subjective matters of taste or opinion, subjectivism or subjectivity. What is the study of art and beauty called? Aesthetics. Which two fields study the natural phenomena and the phenomena of society? That is philosophy and science. And now it's time for the next lightning round with Okadu. You'll need to choose a representative who will be answering for your team.
I am Mikhaila Abad, and I will be representing Okadu.
All right, your topic is famous quotes. You will have 1 minute and 10 seconds to answer. Each question is worth 20 points for a possible total of 200 points. And remember, you can pass at any time, and if we have time, we can go back to the questions you passed on. All right, and time starts now. He is known as one of the most famous emperors of Greece. He supposedly yelled these words as he was being assassinated.
Pass.
Who said forgiveness is the fragrance that the violet sheds on the heel that has crushed it?
Pass.
This famous African-American woman was a poet, actress, singer, and composer who said, I come as one, but I stand as 10,000.
Pass.
This great martial artist and actor said, you must be shapeless, formless, like water. When you pour water in a cup, it becomes the cup. When you pour water in a bottle, it becomes the bottle. Water can drip and it can crash. Become like water, my friend.
Bruce Lee?
That is correct. Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. Which president said this?
Abraham Lincoln?
That is incorrect. A famous cartoon character created by Elise Chrysler Cigar in 1929, who is a humble sailor who always eats his spinach, says, I am what I am,
Popeye?
And that is correct. How can you believe that you are not worthy of yourself? Was said by a best-selling author, frequent guest.
Time's up.
I'll finish the question. How could you believe that you are not worthy of yourself? Was said by a best-selling author, frequent guest on the Oprah Winfrey Show and Network, and was a resident of Guam.
Pass.
Okay. And that is the end of our lightning round. You answered 2 correctly for a total of 40 points. And of course, I'll go over the questions that you missed. He's known as one of the most famous emperors of Greece. He supposedly yelled these words as he was being assassinated. Et tu, Brute. Who said forgiveness is the fragrance the violet sheds on the heel that has crushed it? Mark Twain. This famous African-American woman was a poet, actress, singer, and composer who said, I come as one, but I stand as 10,000. Maya Angelou. Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. Which president said this? John F. Kennedy. And we didn't get to these questions, but Forrest Gump's character said these words about life always being a surprise. Life is like a box of chocolates. You never know what you're going to get. As Neil Armstrong descended the ladder and took his first step on the moon, he said, that's one step for man, one great leap for mankind. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you is known as what? And that is the golden rule. And the final score is JFK with 410 points and Okudu with 270 points. Congratulations, John F. Kennedy!
Good job to all of our students and coaches, and thank you to the wonderful production team at PBS Guam.
I hope you all did well answering the questions at home. Join us again
for another energizing episode of the Academic Challenge Bowl 50th anniversary.